Hi guys, this is going to be a quick amendment to the video that I put up yesterday on how to download offline game roster files from Operation Sports, a deep dive commentary lecture. I did neglect one thing to show you guys in that video. In the latter part, I was showing you guys about how to change the extension on a file name that you download so that it'll also appear in the save roster file of NCAA Football 13. Well, I did a quick edit, and when I did that, I cut out the part where I should have been showing you guys how to do that. So I'm going to do that right now, real quick. This is how you create a file extension name for a roster save file. Okay, so let's go into the game and you'll see what I'm talking about. Get my controller here and we'll enter the game. As you know, that was quite a project that I embarked on yesterday, because nobody's ever done it. They don't show you all the steps to download a Operation Sports roster file. So that was my attempt to make it easier for a lot of people who want these older rosters to obtain them. But I did neglect this one part. I didn't do it in the first part I showed you. So it's really elementary, but some people, you know, are novice and they don't catch on to certain things quickly. So I wanted to make sure that you understood how to do this, okay? I'll explain further when I get in here. Just so you know, it works. It takes a little time to load in the game. And on the new version of OBS, it does that. And on the old version of OBS, if you had a PS3, you couldn't record the XM screens and stuff like that without, when it switched to the game, it shutting off automatically your feed, your video feed. So that's an upgrade from OBS. So now we're going to go in. And you might have noticed also yesterday that the latter part was louder than the first part of the video. That's something I tried to avoid, but I didn't do it well. So sorry about the soft-spoken tones in the first part of the video, and then it got loud on you in the last part. You know, just a little technical glitch, but I'll work it out. But right now you should be hearing, you're hearing the fan on my computer and all kind of ambient sounds. Don't let that deter you from listening to this full video. So we're almost 4 minutes in now. Let me go down here and show you how to load these files. You go down to where you see the referee's shirt, and that's how you know that's where you load the file management. You go to file management, and I'm going to do this first. I'm going to load the rosters so I can explain what I'm doing here. ABC is something I just created because I couldn't quite remember how to create a new file within NCAA Football 13. But the other one underneath it, that's the file extension that you have to change in order to load your Operation Sports file into the PS3 file on the desktop. So this is the part I skipped. You can see it's up there, so that means it got put in. But I didn't show you how I put it in there. So here's how you would do that. I'm going to back out here. And I'm going to go under Save. And that's a new file. And I'm just going by memory here. So I might mess it up, but I don't think I will. Okay, so on the new one, you would do this. You would type in KB21. I think it's 2122. Week. One. Now it might tell me this file already exists. Do you want to override it? I'm going to say no. But this is how you would create that file. I neglected to show you this part yesterday. Okay? So this is part two, just like a patch. It might let me do it twice. We'll see. Now, it's asking me, do I want to override? And I don't. I just wanted to show you guys how to do it. You will be starting from a new jump off point, and you'll be creating this file new. And this would be the file that you would sync up, like I said, with the download that you get from Operation Sports. The file would have this extension on it. Okay? So if you didn't view the first video, this makes no sense to you. But if you saw the first video and at the end you were kind of confused on how to do that, this will clear it up for you. But I can't save this naturally because it would erase all my information that I transferred from Operation Sports into this file. Just wanted to show you how to make the file extension into a roster save. Okay, so I'm going to hit the back button on this and not do it, but this is how you do it. Hopefully this will clear up a misunderstanding for some of you. I think most of you understood from the first part how to create a roster file that will come up in the utility part of the XM screen. When you push it in, it says utility file for PS3. This would be the file that would come up when you enter into that. And this would be the one that you would make your hard edit from the file that's on the desktop. Like I said, this makes no sense to you. If you didn't view the video, it sounded like a bunch of garbage. But this is my way of correcting maybe a mistake that I made in editing. Hopefully not. So far, the reception of the video is very good, so I'm assuming that most of you guys understood. But I wanted to make it a thorough video. So that's it. I just wanted to do this so that you guys would understand how to do it. Now I'm going to back out to show you. Do you want to cancel? Yes, I do. Okay. Now, just to show you, once you do all of the things that I just showed you, and you go out and you load that file, the one that I just simulated a creation for, this is what it'll look like when you finish the job, so to speak. Okay, I'm loading it now. This is the one from yesterday. Okay? Even though it's got today's date on it. Actually, it was yesterday evening, past midnight that I did it, so I guess technically that's correct, that date that was on there. But now we're going to go out and go to right here and look at the depth chart. Okay, and this is where Bryce Young, this is for all the guys who want to, who don't have NCAA 14, but you got NCAA 13, and you want an up-to-date or close to up-to-date file as you can get. This is actually last year's roster, not this year coming, but last year where Bryce Young was still on Alabama, and that's the proof of in the pudding, so to speak. We go there and we look at Bryce Young, and then you'll know that you could do the same thing with NCAA Football 13 as people have been doing with NCAA 14 all these years, even though NCAA 14 is superior because the server is still up and you can do all this via the file sharing. This is an offline save. That's why the title of the video was contained offline roster. Okay, just so you get used to the terminology. So you see it there. Most people didn't know you could do this. That's why I did it too. Okay? So all you guys who got NCAA 13, but you don't have 14, you can have up-to-date rosters too. They're looking out for you at Operation Sports. All right, guys. Thanks for watching that first video. I appreciate it. And hopefully this helped some of you who were pondering, well, how do I save that file? Well, this is how you do it. Okay? All right. This is done all before you do whatever you do with the Operation Sports file. I don't want to make it more confusing. I'm going to leave now. That's it. You should get it. All right. Bye.